The new MacBook Pro 2022 model will be coming with an M2 chipset with even more cores than what we had with the M1. The great news is the 10-core M2 power has been revealed in today's report. Let's go over the details about this report and also cover details about the specs for the new MacBook Pro, including screen size, design, and also other details, of course, and give you the latest on the MacBook Pro M2 release date and price as well. But first, let's jump in there with what MacBook Pro is essentially being upgraded. So for a long time, Apple have always provided a smaller screen, lower spec MacBook Pro and a higher tier MacBook Pro for at least 10 years now. Now, mainly with this, we've had the likes of an Intel i5 chipset in the lower spec 13-inch MacBook Pro, and then we've had an i7 chipset in the same chassis as a 13-inch MacBook Pro, but you basically got an additional couple of ports, for example, on that design. And basically, that's been the fundamentals of the MacBook Pro 13-inch for, say, the last 10 years. However, a big change came in 2020 and also in 2021. The biggest change in 2020 was the introduction of the M1 chipset at the end of that year that came out in the likes of the Mac Mini, the MacBook Air, and of course the MacBook Pro 13-inch lower spec model. There were no design changes, just a chipset under the hood being changed from an Intel one to an Apple Silicon M1 chipset. However, at the end of 2021, we got the introduction of the new M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset, and we also got a brand new design 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pro. Those MacBook Pros distinguished themselves in being more powerful than the current M1 MacBook Pro that came out the year before. However, it has been nearly 18 months since that M1 MacBook Pro came out, and Apple are now looking to upgrade this exact model with an M2 chipset inside it. But focusing on the M2 chipset, we've been advised that the M2 chipset is looking to have a big upgrade in performance with its 8-core CPU to begin with. We've been told we'll be getting the same 8-core setup, so 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. However, in overall performance, just for the CPU on its own, we could be getting an 8-10% increase of single core over the M1. But for multi-core, things increase quite a bit here. It will be increasing up to 20% according to these estimates from GSM Arena. But the greatest change is in GPU for the M2 chipset. We've been advised that we'll be getting 2 more additional cores added to the current M1 8-core GPU option, bringing this up to a total of 10 GPU cores. This report is coming from Mark Gurman, and with these 2 extra cores alone, we'd be getting a 25% increase in power just for those 2 additional cores. However, with Apple making these cores more powerful, as this is the next generation chipset, it is more likely that with all of these cores combined, we could be getting 40-45% increase of graphical performance over the current M1. This in return is making the M2 a real powerhouse, and it will just be behind the multi-core performance of the M1 Pro binned CPU and GPU option that you can get in the 14-inch MacBook Pro. Now, having said all of that, at this stage, I will mention that all leaks are not 100% proof that they will come true with the new MacBooks. However, if you are watching this video, then you are as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the new MacBooks anyway. So the next question is on release date. So up to very recently, the expected release date of a device with an M2 chipset was targeted at the end of 2022. It was believed that Apple would want to use the M1 variant chipsets out on all of their devices before focusing on any M2 devices, and that could still be the case. However, recent leaks showing us registrations of those new MacBook and also those new desktops has got us thinking that the new MacBooks or desktops with an M2 chipset could be coming far sooner. However, most of that report can now be quashed now because Mark Gurman, DigiTimes, and the guy who predicted that the 14 and 16-inch MacBooks would have a notch inside it have actually not come true. We instead, at the peak performance event, actually got a new Mac, and this was the Mac Studio, and with that new M1 Ultra inside it. The question is, when is the new MacBook coming out? Well, based on previous years of Apple mainly introducing Macs in spring or fall time, and that the spring event is now done, it's most likely that we will see it in fall for October or November time. Over the last 10 years, Apple will normally do an event in mid-October to early November time, showing new Macs, and this year we're expecting the same, but for MacBooks at this point. Whenever this event date is happening, and to be honest, if it's going to be leaked or if it's official, I will let you guys know. However, as mentioned, the time period is most likely going to be around mid-October to early November time. So next of all is the price, and the best way to do this is a review of the specs as well. So looking at the new MacBook Pro M2, it is possible, and looking at leaks, that we're going to be getting a 13.3 inch LED Retina display with a resolution of 2560 by 1600. This does mean that Apple again will be using the same design that they have used before, like in the likes of the M1 MacBook Pro and MacBook Pros for the last sort of 5 to 6 years. This is keeping the cost down, as you'll see further on in this review of the specs and the prices. The actual storage amounts that we'll be getting is 256 GB all the way up to 2 TB, and then we'll be getting that M2 chipset inside it that will come with an 8-core CPU and also for the first time a 10-core GPU. So two more cores up on the GPU that's in the likes of the M1 chipset. Then on top of this as well, we'll get the choice of 8 GB or 16 GB of RAM. It will be an aluminium body again, and it will have 2 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, very similar to the M1 MacBook Pro. We'll also get that same touch bar design as we have had before, and the colors will come in space gray and also silver. The webcam will be that new 720p camera with the likes of using the actual Neural engine inside the MacBook Pro with the M2 chipset to enhance the picture, but battery life should be up a little bit more with the enhancements and the efficiency in M2, so we could get up to 23 hours battery life now. The price, starting with the 8 GB of RAM option with the lowest spec with 256 GB, will come in at $1,299, the same price as the M1 MacBook Pro right now. Then again, for the 512 GB model, $1,499, 1 TB, $1,699, and then the 2 TB option at $2,099. Obviously, if you do change the RAM around, and also if you change your storage around, you will get different prices on this. But in any case, that is a summary of the new MacBook Pro M2. In my opinion, it is really exciting that Apple are bringing on the next generation of chipsets inside their devices, but I do have some questions around the design this time, that Apple do need to make some changes there. But anyway, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do make sure that you like the video, and also at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you really soon.